Greetings, fellow humans, Suburban Herb here, and good googly moogly, it's harvest time. This week, we'll take one last look at the girls, discuss the grow's pertinent deets, and finally, everybody's favorite, we'll reveal the yield. Here they are, the stars of the show, my girls, my girls, my girls. If you've been paying attention at all, you'll know that standing here are four white widows from Crop King Seeds and two anonymous bag seeds allegedly from the House of Red Dragons. I grew these six plants in a 4x4 tray within a 6x4 tent, maintaining the environment with a 6-inch VivoSun carbon filter exhaust fan, a 6-liter Lavoit humidifier, and a 500-watt heater from Amazon. The base nutrients I used were from Growing Edge Technologies, and they seemed to give my plants everything they needed. Take one last look, as next time you see these ladies, they will be less leafy, but more dead. Poof. Fear not, says Blitz. We have some backups next door in the 4x4. Despite a week one newt burn, everybody now looks happy and healthy. By all rights, these girls in the 2-gallon fabric pots will be transplanted by now, as their roots are most likely starting to feel a little confined in these pots. However, these are crazy times, so gathering what we needed for our grows in a timely manner has been challenging. But we are developing pandemic-level patience, and it still looks like we'll have a great summer growing season, and these girls will be out under the sun in less than a week. For that reason, I'm not bothering with any low-stress training, as in a few days they will be getting 2,000 PPFD directly from the sun, enough to penetrate their tiny canopies. They've mostly all been topped, however. All the photo periods were topped, and one of the three autoflowers. I topped one of the autos to test if outdoors, due to the increased light power and CO2, autos might recover fast enough after topping to increase yield. We shall see. One other comparison test of sorts that we'll be conducting this summer is we'll have the same plants growing outdoors, both organically and with synthetic newts. So, it will be interesting to compare the two. These strains, all from Dr. Green Thumb Seeds, are Iranian Diesel, Iranian G13, Iranian Autoflower, and finally, in the 5-gallon pots, waiting to move next door to the 6x4, are Gorilla Glues number 4. Now, let's talk harvesting, trimming, curing, and yield. Last video, I ballparked the trimming time for last harvest at 20 person hours. I suspect now it was closer to 30, as that is about what it took this time. If your plants are still growing, you still have time to order a multi-pack of trimmers, change your personality, and make some friends. The White Widow buds were small but hard and dense. The Red Dragons were large but light and turned out to be easier to trim than the broader leafed indica. Both have pleasant aromas and even before curing are pretty smooth. We intend to cure between 2 weeks to 2 months, willpower permitting. Mason jars work perfectly for curing. However, once your harvest get to a certain size, you're talking about messing with dozens of jars multiple times a day. Going forward, I'll use the $14 Gamma Seal and a food safe bucket every time. Cheaper and easier. Now, let's talk yield. Starting with sweet little Integrity. The White Widow, you may remember, was vegged beside her sisters in the 6x4, but was then flowered under an 800-watt LED in my dining room. Despite a critically cold week during flower, she soldiered through and produced 50 grams of sweet as pie bud. About what I expected from that light, but with better conditions, I think we could do better. Now, let's move on to the occupants of the Big Ten and see if we hit our target of 1 pound like we did for the last grow. The four White Widows are all curing together in the Gamma Sealed bucket. The two Red Dragons are in the mason jars and the Tupperware. I weighed the Red Dragons separately to see if the top one yielded more, as it had twice the colas, and yet, the top dragon weighed 4.16 ounces and untopped 3.37 ounces for a total of 7.53 ounces. The four White Widows were all weighed together in two batches and in total came to 13.72 ounces. So, the grand total for the 4x4 space was a little over 21 ounces or 595 grams, about 35 grams more than my four plants last grow. And that goes to show, it's not the number of plants, it's the size of the canopy. I learned my lesson, four plants max for a 4x4 space. That's my second grow ever in the books, but don't go anywhere as we are days away from having outdoor content to join the indoor. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed by now, I really have to question your critical thinking skills. See you next week.